All right, here we go. Welcome back to Excelsior, Lysandia, and so on. So, I said that I needed to be looking it up. I don't, because on the map, it actually... Sorry. Boop. There we go. See? In the north, there, the small island north of Pipsley. That is Carth Whitlaw's hut. So I didn't actually need to open a walkthrough or anything like that. So that's good. What we're going to do now is we're just going to go there and we're going to do it. We're going to do it. I'm going to talk to him and he will probably send us around the world again to, to find stuff, whatever he needs to, make the thing that we then need to get the thing. See, that's how it goes. All right. So far, so good. So far, so fantastic. Fantastically good. Oops. Okay, let's... So we're at the Forgotten Pits. So we're going to do the thing that we always do. We're going to sail around and around and around. And once we have done that, we will... We will get to the hut. We actually were there before, like when we were exploring and so on. We entered the hut, I think, but the guy probably just told us to fuck off or something. Okay. But, yeah. Yeah. We're getting there. I'm going to do all the FedExing that the game demands from me. Because I have the patience of a saint. I don't actually, but it really helps to be recording this, you know? I would not be playing this game if I weren't. I would have said, fuck this! A long time ago. And it's a good exercise in patience. Because, yeah. It was always kind of a problem for me. Patience and this kind of stuff. Okay, there we go. I think now we are at the hut. And let's see if we can find him somewhere. Okay, there we go. That looks like... You look like Carth Whibblebore. Let's talk to him. You explain to Carth... You explain to Carth the problem of retrieving the crystal. The crystal jar from the nothingness of Slavic's void. Is his first reply. Perhaps you do not comprehend the full barbarousness of the one who stands before you. I happen to be the greatest inventor in... Oh yeah, he was the inventor type. Wasn't there something about an airship? Oh god, that would be so good to have. I happen to be the greatest inventor in all the land, and I do not deal with such trivial matters. A crystal jar? Pho! Why not just take any jar from the grocer's spice rack? I've work to attend to. You frown with disappointment and begin to walk away. You no sooner reach the door, which we are outside of anyways, when Carth speaks up suddenly. But it does pose an interesting mechanical challenge. You don't even know where the jar is and why we need that. From a strictly theoretical point of view, of course. Let me think for a moment. He pauses for quite a bit more than a moment before continuing. Perhaps you have noticed the exquisite bird perched on my shoulder. You notice for the first time a small songbird resting quietly near Carth's ear. This bird is purely mechanical. It is indistinguishable from the real thing on the outside. But were I to open it up, you would find an intricate web of gears, bearings, and levers. I built it myself. No, applause is not necessary. I know, marvelous. But I must confess that this particular model needed a slight magical charm to function properly. Wait, you said that magic is dissipated within the void. This bird cannot help you. Do not despair, though. I have spent many seasons working on my magnum opus. It is the most sophisticated mechanical device ever constructed, if I do say so myself. It is a clockwork cockatiel, which which functions entirely without magic. You may ask how a bird can help with your problem. I may, yes. He pauses, and it takes you a few moments to realize that this was not a rhetorical statement. You ask the required question, and Karth continues. Excellent question. My clockwork cockatiel, once it is wound up, can fly through the void, grab the jar with its feet, and return it safely to land. No airship. Karth carefully produces a beautiful bird from a shelf and presents it to you. You may borrow my cockatiel for expressly that purpose. However, there's one small complication. The only wind-up key I made unfortunately broke during an accident in my workshop. It will be up to you to forge a second key. The cockatiel, however, is so finely crafted that only a key made of pure untainted animal will activate it. I lost the mold for this key in a card game with a slick gambler living in Pibsley. Now that is at least nearby. In addition, Aramel is a rare resource, so it may be a challenge to have such a key forged, but good luck to you. Take note, this is a loan. I wish my cockatiel returned in addition to the key you produce. A fair offering, if I have ever heard one. Be sure to take special care of the clockwork bird. You take the object from Karth and carefully tuck it away. Clockwork cockatiel. Okay, we already have the thing. Now we just need to make a thing. And for that, we need to go to mold in Pibsley plus Aramel. Okay, and we don't know where to find the Aramel, so this is already promising to be quite interesting. Do I actually have the... No, I don't. Okay. Alright, so Pibsley is right here. Let's just disembark here and go to Pibsley. I think this might be Pibsley. Yes. So he has gambled it away, right? The Ranger, Mystical Beauty, so who are you? Stockshire, quite a few brawls at the tavern, we already did that aeons ago. Oh, that's actually the guy, okay. You cautiously greet the cutthroat, who gruffly responds. You remind me of that scoundrel, Karth Whitlaw, and that's not a compliment, mind you. Karth couldn't win a game of Three Crowns up if his life Oh, we've never played this before. Oh dear. Well, let's see. That's always the first time. If his life depended on it. In fact, the last time we engaged in such a game, he ran out of gold pieces so quickly he resorted to using collateral. The items he offered were devoid of value, but out of pity I agreed to it. He lost, of course, and I became the proud owner of this odd piece of iron. Ferg, as his name turned out to be, holds up a block of iron with a thin set of grooves etched into it. It resembles the mold of a fine key. I note your interest in this item. You may have it if you want it. Oh no, we don't need to play. Okay, just 500 gold pieces. Karth put its value at... it's probably be more. At 500 gold pieces. But knowing how he habitually overestimates the value of his wares, I will give it up for a prize, of course. I will give it up for 250. Oh yes, of course. We have all the stuff. And we have the mold. And now we need to find out how to get Aramel. Fuck me. Okay. How many keys do we still have? Oh, we have more than enough. Okay. Let's talk to these people for now. Maybe we actually get information from here. You have traveled far and wide, but you have no idea about anything. Idiots. Minor healing? Nah, I don't need that. No, I don't want to leave as well. You must practice often. Yeah, you do. Now, man. Okay. And we probably won't find it out from here. We are going to take a look at the map. Oh yeah, that was actually where you could get the gauntlets of might. Apple cheese, lake peach, torch. Let's get 99 peaches. Because peaches are delicious. I have 99 peaches, but you ain't one. What? Okay, so this is not good. So we don't know where to go. Let's take a look at the map. Let's bring up the map. Boom, there we go. Yeah, I don't know. There's nothing. Keep Iron Thread, keep Flare. Borinthia. Huh. Nope. God, pits. It can't be underground, actually. Because, we were in all the... Yeah, that's weird, right? We were in all the dungeons already. And none of them... one of the keeps, maybe? Keep Iron Thread? There was a riddle in front of Keep Iron Thread. Keep Flare. Is that the last one, actually? Keep Flare? That we can still go to? Huh. Don't even know. Yeah. I think Keep Flare and Keep Iron Thread are the last dungeons that we have still left. That's cool. Yeah. Indeed, they are. But this doesn't really help us. I mean, I could do this honestly and just check out those dungeons. Okay, let's go to where Keep Iron Thread is, because that's basically on the path to Keep Flare as well. Yeah, let's just do that, you know? I mean, I've been taking extremely long for this already. It doesn't matter if it's any longer. So, how about we just do that? Yeah, those are actually the... Aren't any more dungeons. And those two. That's kind of cool. I think we're actually getting to the end. We probably need to... for this one, we need to go into one of the dungeons. And for the next thing, we need to go into the next dungeon. And probably all around the world again. As always. But... and then that might be it. We will have to probably go to the King of... Bollocks in Excelsior, and he will be possessed by some kind of terrible demon, probably, and then we need to kill the demon and then the game is done. This is how I predict this to go. Don't know if that's actually true, probably not, we're going to see, but this is how I expect this, because this is usually how fantasy stuff goes. Auto save, yes, disembark, inspect, you find nothing, of course not. Yeah, you need to get securely locked and we signpost remains silent. Okay, we can't do anything with that actually. A chattering signpost, but okay. So Iron Thread is not actually available for us for now. Okay, that's good, because that means if I got this right, then I'm just gonna leave the map open for now. If I got this right, the Keep Flare is actually the only thing that we have left to go to. And yeah, I mean, I don't know why they would be mining stuff in a keep. So maybe that's also not true. Maybe It's not the Saturnium rock, is it? Probably not. We still have never found any use for the Saturnium rock as well, which is kind of strange. Huh. I wonder when that will come into play, or if it ever will be. Oh well, we're gonna see. So, Keepflare, as you can see, is north of Barrows, so of course we do need to retrace those steps again. Okay, let's not get killed. Almost invalid spell. Sorry. I lost a bunch of health over time, but I did not pay any attention to that. Okay, so we're north of Barrows now, so Keepflare. I think that's actually the first dungeon I ever went into, wasn't it? Yeah. Now we're in Keepflare. Okay. I'm just gonna explore this and we're going to see if we're going to get anywhere. Here, right? I mean, I don't know. Could be the case. If it isn't, we then will again have explored a dungeon, which may be of use for later. So, yeah. Okay. Let's take a good look around here. Well, that looks like a riddle with all the signposts again. Inspect. No, bollocks. Okay, one moment. Da, da, da. Keepflare riddle. Sign. I give you twice as many as the previous time thereafter. Well, let's do the old thing of collecting every hint. Okay, and there's a chattering signpost in the middle. Okay. Classic riddle. Classic Excelsior riddle. Inspect. Okay, yeah, that's this, again, some kind of mathematical thing. How many small sacks can you fill with the gold that... Why is that so long? That you receive between a afternoon and a... Okay, and this is some kind of time thing. Some kind of time riddle. And this is probably what opens when we have solved the riddle. There seem to be four signposts as well. Inspect this one. Okay, yep. Sign. Small sack can carry one short of a dozen and four score gold coins. Okay. Oops, inspect. Ah, okay. That is probably the first one. I give you one gold coin the first time the minute hand crosses the hour hand on the 13. What the fuck is this? 13-hour clock. Okay, so let's review this. I give you one gold coin the first time the minute hand crosses the hour hand on the 13-hour clock. 13-hour clock, the first time, and crosses the hour hand. That happens once an hour. I give you twice as many as the previous time thereafter. So we got 1, 2, 4, and so on. Exponential growth. How many small sacks can you fill with the gold that you can receive between a quarter hour afternoon? I will have to draw up a little clock. So I will do that. And yeah, this is already 20 minutes. So I will think about it for a minute. This does not seem hard. So this is, I think this is pretty easy. I'm going to end the video here. And in the next video, we're going to solve this riddle. And yeah. And stuff. Right? Right. And then we're going to continue down here and see if we find anything. All right. See you next time.